What's up, y'all? So today I'm gonna be doing my brows with an old favorite of mine. This is the Ruby Kisses HD gel liner in the color dark brown. I don't know if they have a color that's a little bit lighter than this as far as like a brown color, but I know they have a black, of course, because it's like a regular gel liner. It's not really meant for your brows, but I used to love using this on my brows, and I used to call them bulletproof brows because this liner right here, it stays. I'm telling you, like, it's a really good liner. The only problem I had with it is that it dries out pretty quick. So that's the only problem I had with it. But like I always do when I start my brows, I always start off with a mattifying primer. Using my Makeup Forever Step 1 mattifying primer. And you really don't need a lot of this. Do not put too much of this on your brows, because it will look a hot mess. So I just brush that up. Use my spoolie, brush everything up since I'm starting from the bottom, and then once I start doing the top, I brush it down. Now this liner may be a little bit too dark for some people. For me, I feel like it's perfect because I like a dark brow. But if you don't like really dark brows, you can either be careful with this or just use a light hand or just try to find a lighter color. So I'm just gonna start in the middle. Baseline. I really like this line. It's so creamy. Then I'm just gonna brush it down. I'll do the other one later. I'm just gonna brush it down, and you're not gonna use a lot of this either. You're only gonna use a tiny amount. Once again, starting in the middle. Just connect that end and point it in. And just fill in the gaps. Try to make sure that tail end is dark. I'm not going in again. I'm just going to take what's left on the brush and then just kind of do a little line right here at the top. Just kind of bring that all together, and then I'm not adding any more color on this brush. I'm just going to take what's right here and just kind of try to drag that in. Because being that this gel liner is so dark, you really don't want to go in with so much product in the beginning of your brow, because it will look so boxy. So now, honestly, if I wanted to, I can just wear a brow like this. But of course, I like to clean up my brows. So yeah, let me go ahead and do the other side, and I'll be back. Okay, so clearly, I thought I was recording, but I wasn't. But what I did was to clean up just to kind of fade out the front part of my brow, what I did was I took this angle brush, and I went into this MAC eyeshadow in Espresso, and it's just a cool tone brown. And all I did was I just took this, just a little bit, I dipped in it a couple of times, and then I just kind of faded out the front part of the brow. Now this part I really don't worry about too much of bringing it closer together, because I'm a white bed anyway. When you're using this gel liner, you really don't want to use too much of it, especially right here in the front part of the brow. You really want to focus most of the color here, because if you put too much of it here, your brows are going to be looking real dark and real boxy. So my concealer, I'm using my favorite concealer, my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NW45. I like this color for my brows. Sometimes I use NW40, depending on what mood I'm in, depending on what look I want to do, depending on if I'm really doing like a dramatic eye look. It all depends. But most of the time, if I'm just either doing my brows or a natural look, I probably use NW45. The brush I'm using to clean up my brows is the MAC 195. Yeah, it's the 195. Alright, now, I also didn't mention this either. Normally when I fill in my brows, before I put on my concealer, that is where I would decide on whether I need to go ahead and start cleaning up my brows as far as like getting rid of any excess hairs. Any stray hairs, it's starting to grow back in, I will go ahead and either clean that up with a razor sometimes I pluck it depending on how many I have. Okay, so to blend out the ends of the concealer, I'm just gonna take this little brush right here. This one is from Lamora Brushes, just a round brush. Any kind of brush you want to use. I just like to use this one because it's a little stiff. And this step is really for just if you make any mistakes on your brows, you can just kind of clean it up with the concealer. Or if you just really like a sharp brow, like me. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and do my other eye and then I'll be back. Okay, so now that I got the concealer on both brows, I'm just gonna let it dry. And normally while I'm waiting on that, I just like to kind of look over them just to see if I have any spots where I put too much concealer over the brows or if I need to conceal a little bit more. I see a spot right over here where I need to just kind of, wait a minute. All right, so that's pretty much what I do as far as my brows. I'm just gonna let these dry and I try to get a close up of what these look like once. Okay, I thought I missed it. What these look like once I let them dry. All right, y'all, so this is what my brows are looking like right now. I really, really like this brow gel, with this eyeliner as a brow gel because it keeps my brows on all day. I used to love this stuff and I think I was watching Chanel H here on YouTube and she used it. And I was like, oh my God, I remember I used to love that. So I had to go back and get it, but yeah, I like it. I like these brows. So I got this from my beauty supply store. It was like $3.99, $4. It's a really good gel liner. You can get the black one if you want to use it for your wing liner. Like I said, the only problem I have with this gel liner is the fact that it kind of seems to dry out quicker than I'm able to use it. But I really, really like this brow, this eyeliner. Like I said, I don't know if they have one that's a little bit lighter, like a light brown. I don't know if they have one of those. I don't even know if they have like, just a regular brow gel. I hope they do. If so, I'm willing to try it out. But anyway, that's it. Thank y'all so much for watching. Be sure to follow me on my socials if you want to see like my day-to-day life. I'm mostly on Snap. I try to post on Instagram as much as I can, but I'm mostly on Snap. So anyway, thank y'all so much for watching. I'll see y'all on my next one. Bye.